A building's carbon footprint is the amount of carbon dioxide that is emitted into the atmosphere over a building's lifetime.
Our built environment contributes about 40% of the CO2. In the atmosphere. The fires in buildings make up about 1 to 2% of the building's carbon footprint, contributing between 25 and 50 million metric tons of CO2 to our environment. And that's the equivalent of 5 to 10 million cars on the highway.
So Jensen Hughes' study on the carbon footprint of building fires and how those could be, and how that carbon footprint could be reduced by portable fire extinguishers relied on data that others had collected. So we took all of that data and put it together and found that the combination of sprinklers and fire extinguishers could reduce the carbon emissions from building fires by about 99% compared to if you didn't have either of those. The easiest way to reduce the amount of carbon dioxide that's released into the atmosphere in a building fire is to suppress that fire as early as you can. So if we're able to put that fire out when it's really small, perhaps by using a portable fire extinguisher, then that's going to minimize the amount of carbon. If those portable fire extinguishers are used, the data shows that they're likely to be used effectively. And if those portable fire extinguishers are used effectively, then what the data shows us is they'll reduce the carbon footprint by about 99% compared to if there was no suppression of that fire and it was allowed to grow uncontrolled.
The bottom line is that we should be encouraging people to install and use portable fire extinguishers in all of their buildings. That is, without a doubt, the very best way to save on the carbon footprint when it comes to building fires.